Jesus and God's people, they would have never painted him to be look like them.
Right.
You understand? That's the importance of knowing who you are.
Right.
That's the importance of you stop doing the evil that they perpetuate against us.
Right.
Because now they got us on autopilot, bro. When we hate each other, we get rap lyrics. They give us a little contract saying, look, I want you to rap about killing your brother. And guess what? We do it.
Right.
And then the youngsters listen to it, and then they go try to play it out.
Bring it out.
It's almost like the rap lyrics is like a skit to a play.
Right.
And they acting out the skit.
Right.
Now our kids is out here killing each other. Where are they getting these switches from to put on Glocks?
Bring it out.
Bring it out.
By your enemies?
Right.
By the possessors that slay you? Saying that this is the image. But in the Bible, we read that he's a dark-skinned man.
That's right.
So that means that this was a lie.
Right.
And he's 2 John verse 7.
You know?
So that means this is a lie.
Right.
Would you want anyone to lie to you? Did your parents tell you about Santa Claus?
Yeah.
How did you feel when you found out that was a lie?
Hurt.
You didn't care?
Nah.
Have you ever been lied to?
Yeah.
Did you like it?
No.
No? So you don't like when someone lies to you?
Right.
Let me show you what the Bible says, the importance of why Jesus' skin color matters. Read that for me.
The book of 2 John, verse 7. For many deceivers are entered into the world.
So the Bible says many, listen, it says many deceivers. Deceivers mean people who lie.
Right.
They have entered into the world. Read on.
For many deceivers are entered into the world who confess not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh.
So it says they confess that Jesus' skin color is this. But we just read that he's dark skinned.
Right.
Look at the brother next to you. His skin looks like that.
Yep.
A little bit darker than you. So that means that Jesus Christ is a what?
Black man.
He's a black man.
That's right.
So do white people like black people? No. So now you see why they are deceivers. They are liars.
Right. Bring it out. Bring it out.
So if they don't like black people, who else do they don't like?
Bring it out.
They don't like Jesus.
Right.
They hate Jesus.
That's right.
They hate God.
Right.
Right.
And guess what? They hate God's people.
That's right.
That's why they do this. Give me Zechariah 11 and 5.
Bring it out.
Because look, once they get us to believe that they are God, they can easily kill us and get away with it.
Right.
They now got us on autopilot where we kill each other.
Right.
So we are literally, we are spiritual KKK members.
Right.
Bring it up. We are KKK members without the hood.
Bring it up.
Read that.
The book of Zechariah, chapter 11 and verse 5. Who possess us, slay them and hold themselves not guilty.
So, bro, you know you Israel?
Yes, sir.
What tribe?
I'm Hebrew.
What tribe you from?
I don't know what.
You don't know yet? Okay, no, he good. You just getting off work?
Just getting off the gig.
Okay, understood.
Yes, sir.
Hey, you gonna be here for a minute? Or you waiting on the bus?
Waiting on the bus.
Okay, well,
I want you to
sit tight real quick. I want you to listen to the scripture real quick. Read it again.
The book of Zechariah, chapter 11, verse 5. Whose possessors slay them.
Now look, bro, you know about the slave trade, right? Come over here, bro. Excuse me. You see these images right here? This is what happened to us when we got off the slave boats. They whipped us, they put chains and yokes of iron on our neck, they raped our women, they fed babies to gators. They ripped babies out of the mother's stomachs and smashed the babies against stones. They fed us to dogs. The Bible says who possessors slay us, meaning the white man possessed us and he kills us, right? I want you to listen, this is very important. Read.
And hold themselves not guilty.
So look, they rule this earth and they are over the judicial system.
Right.
So when they do something wrong to you, they go to court and they get charged not guilty.
Right.
Sometimes they don't even go to court. They don't even press charges on themselves.
Deep.
But if you do something wrong, what happens? Guilty. Before you even go to court. You're guilty just by your skin color.
Bring it out.
You're guilty because of your bloodline.
Right.
Because they hate Jesus.
Yeah.
They hate God's people. Because if they didn't hate Jesus and God's people, they would have never painted him to be looked like them.
Right.
You understand? That's the importance of knowing who you are.
Right.
That's the importance of you stop doing the evil that they perpetuate against us.
Right.
Because now they got us on autopilot, bro. When we hate each other, we get rap lyrics. They give us a little contract saying, look, I want you to rap about killing your brother. And guess what? We do it.
Right.
And then the youngsters listen to it, and then they go try to play it out.
Bring it out.
It's almost like the rap lyrics is like a skit to a play.
Right.
And they acting out the skit.
Right.
Now our kids is out here killing each other. Where are they getting these switches from to put on Glocks?
Bring it out.
Bring it out.
By your enemies.
Right.
By the possessors that slay you. You understand?
Yeah.
Read it again.
Whose possessors slay them and hold themselves not guilty.
So that's going into what I just said about the Glocks. They give you switches to put on the Glocks. And then they tell you to listen to this music. They say, kill the ops. Kill the ops. Kill the ops.
Right.
And they make you think your ops is you.
Bring it out.
They telling you to kill yourself if you do it. You understand? That's why you gotta stop listening to that music.
Give me a first Corinthians 15:33.
So look, bro, you listen to rap music? What about you?
You gotta
you listen
B-roll
to rap music? What you listen to?
Add B-roll? It's on the phone though.
You listen to drill? Drill, drill, kill, kill, kill. What's your favorite drill artist? You ain't got one? All Chicago drill or New York drill?
Chicago.
So, what's that dude? NPTF, Nook or something? Nook or something? Who? PNK Nook. You like LeVon? King Von. I call him LeVon. No disrespect to the brother. You know what I'm saying? But when you do the things you do, to me, you is little.
Yeah.
That's child. That's a child mindset.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's little stuff. Big stuff is what? Bringing life to your brothers.
Bring it out.
You know what I'm saying? What we doing? We trying to get you to stop killing your brothers. Stop listening to that drill music. God says to stop listening to that drill music. Do you believe in God? Listen to what God says.
Bring it out.
The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 33.
Yeah.
Be not deceived.
The Bible says, be not deceived. Remember, the white man deceived us by giving us an image that says that he is God.
Right.
So now he said, be not deceived again. Read.
Evil communications corrupt good manners.
So the Bible says evil communication. When you listen to rap music, isn't that communication?
Right.
So drill music, do you think it's good or evil? It's evil. He says evil communication corrupts what?
Good manners.
Now, I know your mother raised you to have good manners, right? Did she raise you to open the door to let a woman walk through?
Yeah.
Did she raise you to cover your mouth when you got a cough?
Yeah.
Did she raise you to say, excuse me, if you accidentally bumped someone?
Yeah.
She raised you, right?
Yeah.
She raised you with good manners. But the Bible says evil communication corrupts good manners.
Bring it out.
Evil communication with how you looking at your brother and want to kill him.
Right.
Evil communication is these drill rappers.
Right. Yeah.
Did you know the same man that painted this man, that painted Jesus to be white, is the same man that owns the record labels that pays our brothers to kill each other?
Yeah.
Did you know that? Brian, did you know that? What's your name, bro?
Vail.
Did you know that? How old is you, Vail? 18. Both of y'all the same age. Right now, you 16. 16 and 18. Bro, what's your name, bro?
I'm Lee.
Lee?
Yeah.
How old are you is?
I'm 23.
23. These your brothers?
Of course.
They listen to drill music. They listen to music that's talking about killing their own brothers. Do you agree with listening to drill music?
No.
No? You listen to it sometimes?
Sometimes.
You want to know what God says about that? Can I share it with you?
Yes.
Read it again. Call it a read.
Bring it out, huh? 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 33.
Bring it out.
Be not deceived. evil communications corrupt good manners.
The reason why I said be not deceived, because usually when these lyrics are spoken, it's a nice catchy melody with it. It's a nice catchy beat. Get you wanna dance, wanna groove. But right. That evil communication gets into your mind, and now you want to play out those lyrics.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? That's why he said, be not deceived, but evil communication. What?
Corrupt good manners.
So it makes you evil. It makes you want to do evil things. Now the presence brought you over here. You had a question?
You want to know why this happened to us.
You want to know why yeah. slavery happened to us?
Yes.
All right, so one of the, you go to a job, right?
Yes.
Where you work at?
You're Amazon.
Amazon's a very strict company. Am I right about that?
Yes, sir.
Everything's based off time. If you late, what happens? You get punished for it. So those are rules, right?
Yes.
You gotta follow the rules when you live and work at? What about you, Brian? If you don't follow the rules, what happens?
Fired.
You get fired or you get in trouble, right? So I want you to look at that flyer again. That happened because we broke rules.
Right.
You got parents, right?
Yeah.
And you ever got whooped by your father or your mother?
Yeah.
It hurt, didn't it?
Yeah.
That's what slavery is. It's a whooping. It just happened to all of us. That's how God deals with his children. You understand?
Yeah.
So that happened because we broke God's rules. Give me Jeremiah 6 and 19.
Bring it up.
Jeremiah 6 and 19 and give me Deuteronomy 28. So bad things, don't bad things happen. Look, come look, bro. Come look, Val. You too. Brian, you too, come closer, bro. So, come look, come closer, bro. These images, these are drawings, but these drawings is based off historic. These things actually happen to us. As you see up top, we picking cotton. This brother right here didn't pick enough cotton. So he got whipped on his back. They packed us on slave ships like sardines. All this happened to us because we didn't want to keep God's rules. We got taken off the west coast of Africa. We got taken from Europe and we came over here to the Americas. Prior to us coming over here, our Hispanic and Native American brothers got conquered by the same deceiver, by the same liar.
Right.
Once they killed them and made them to assimilate to their ways, that's when they brought us over. And they did this to us.
Bring it out.
But God made that happen because we didn't want to listen to him.
Right.
Read that in Jeremiah 6 and 19.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 6 and verse 19.
Yeah.
Hear, O earth, behold, I will bring evil upon his people, even the fruit of their thoughts, because they have not hearkened unto my words, nor to my law, but rejected.
So God said he's going to bring evil on us. Don't you think this is evil, bro? This is evil. God brought evil on us because we reject what he wanted to do with us. We reject what he told us to do. You know what I'm saying? So if you tell your son, look, don't cross when the light turns red, or I'm going to whoop your butt, or something bad is going to happen to you. Guess what happens if he crosses the street while the light is red? He get hit by a car. So it's a cause and effect.
Deep.
So if you do good, good comes to you. If you do bad, bad comes to you. That's what God is saying.
Right.
That's why that happened to us.
We
wasn't doing, we still not doing good right now. Right now we're not doing good. Because you just came from work or you about to go to work. You just came from work. Today is a day where you're not supposed to work.
Right.
Today is the day God says all my children don't work.
Right.
Don't cook anything. Don't buy anything. Don't sell anything.
Right.
You're supposed to be doing what we doing, but you didn't know that. So a lot of us do bad and ignorant. That's why we out here to show our people, look, we gotta stop. We gotta stop the bleed before we bleed out as a people and die. Give me Deuteronomy 28, verse 15.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 8, and verse 15.
You know?
It shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So God said these evil things is going to come on us if we don't listen to them. That's what this scripture pretty much said.
Bring it up.
In a nutshell. So just imagine your mom and dad telling you, son, keep your room clean. If you don't clean your room, I'm gonna whoop your butt.
Right.
That's what God is saying to us in a nutshell. You understand that? Give me verse 46.
Bring it on.
Look up Deuteronomy chapter 8 at 28 and verse 46. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder, and upon thee seed forever. So God said, look, he said, I'm gonna bring these curses on you for a sign. What's your nationality, bro?
What?
You black? So you the same color as this? See this? That's black, right? You feel me? So you're not the same color as this. So you're not the same color as these pants. Can you go to a land called black?
Bring it out!
It doesn't exist, do it. So God said, that's a curse for you not knowing where you come from.
Right.
You not knowing your nationality. When you filled out that application to work at Amazon, what list of nationality did it give you? Right, because the deceiver doesn't even want you to know. That's why we coming out here to show our brothers your true nationality is that you from the nation of Israel. Look at this sign down here, bro. Come look at this sign. Come look at this sign.
Read out.
Right here. So Israel had 12 sons. You see that, bro? Israel had 12 sons. This is what God calls us right here, all the way down. Judah. When you look on the left of this or to your right, this is what the deceiver or the oppressor calls us. American black. So the deceiver doesn't want you to know that you're from the tribe of Judah, from the nation of Israel. Did you know that, sis? Did you know you're from the nation of Israel? God calls the nation of Israel the greatest people on earth.
Right.
He says, look, when you deal with me, you have power over the nations.
That's right.
But when you don't deal with me, you got to go into slavery.
Right.
You got to work for a living. You got to work paycheck to paycheck, barely making ends meet. Nobody out here is really making it, bro.
Bring it out.
Not one person. We all in the same condition.
That's right.
The only difference between me and you is that I know who I am according to the Bible.
Right.
And I'm doing something about it by trying to get you over here.
Right.
That's the only difference. Me and you the same thing. But you got to repent. You got to stop the bleeding before we bleed out, bro.
Right.
You understand? Because look, when you go down the street, you're going to see like 5, 15-year-olds talking about kill, 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 murder, murder, murder. And they're going to act that out. Then you're going to see our sisters talk about my coochie pink, my booty hole brown. I'm about to go get me an abortion. I'm about to go eat these Plan B pills. I'm about to have sex with 5 men, unprotected, get diseases, and spread it all over the west side of Chicago. So you got to speak up against that.
Right.
If not, we gonna continue in this dead state right here.
Right.
Slavery.
What is a nation? Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is men leading by example. Nation is women's support. Nation is children with roles.